To the person sitting next to you, greet them, smile, shake their hands. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. If you have your Bible, just quickly turn to Psalms 130. Psalms 130, please. If you got an electronic device that's got a Bible app on it, come to verse 3 of Psalms 130. Verse 3. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Psalms 130, verse 3. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Perhaps I can put it up on the screen here for us. All this translation. Just bear with me for a couple of minutes. Hallelujah. Greet somebody sitting next to you and says, Hallelujah. Just talk to them. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ask them, has God been good to you today? What has Parmeshwar done for you today? Hallelujah. Ask them, share your testimony with me, please. Say something to them. Praise the Lord. Not much talking tonight. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Anybody want to testify? God is good.
All the time. God is good.
Hallelujah. Anybody want to testify? Because God has been so good to you. Has God done anything in your life?
Amen.
Has God answered any prayer?
Amen.
Yes.
Has God blessed you?
Yes.
Okay. Would you like to testify about it? No, not really. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. So that's a scripture in all these different translations, eh? So, depends on how you want it. So it's all there. Psalms 130 verse 3. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Look at the New Living Translation down here. Can everybody see that from the back?
Amen.
All right, at the back. You know, they say the front. Can you read it there? Verse 3, read it together with me. 2, 3.
Lord, if you have our sins, who, O Lord, could ever survive?
Remember that, eh? If God were to keep a record of all the sins we've committed, none of us deserve salvation. Eh? None of us deserve salvation because of the things we have done. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That's what the psalmist say. Eh? If God were to keep a record of all our sins, none of us deserve salvation. Praise the Lord. But salvation is not what we deserve, eh? Salvation is the mercy of God.
Amen.
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 I'm preaching already. I better turn it off. Praise the Lord. Pastor, sorry. Preaching. Hallelujah. Okay, those are the two scriptures that we've been touching. Can you please, hallelujah, read it for me?
That if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart, that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation.
So we believe with the
heart,
and we confess with the
mouth.
Do we believe with the mind?
No.
Do we believe with the mouth?
Yes.
No.
Who said yes? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We believe with the heart and we confess with the mouth. Amen?
Amen.
That's clear. Praise the Lord. It's good to laugh in church, eh? You can laugh. Eh? You know, you can laugh in church if you want to laugh. Laugh. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We're not going to say shh. Eh? But if you become a distraction, we'll tell you to shh. Tone it down a bit, please. A second one, please.
Moses, I say to you, he who believes in me has
hallelujah. Pastor, this is a good screen, eh?
Yeah.
I walked in and I saw the screen. I said, wow! Praise the Lord. Yeah. Hallelujah. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Everybody understand that, eh?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Let's go to our teaching tonight. Has everybody been enjoying the teaching? Any questions? No? No questions? So, Pastor, we must be doing a good job. Praise the Lord. Because everybody understood it. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. This is the question for us. Can a Christian lose their salvation? Can a Christian lose their salvation?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to find out in a minute. Eh? Praise the Lord. Who's not sure? Put your hands up if you're, I don't know. I haven't got a clue. Don't know. All right, good. So we're going to find out. Read the first paragraph, please. 2, 3.
Before this question is answered, the term Christian must be defined. A Christian is not a person who has said a prayer. Oh, God, grant us all grace in the Christian family.
Somebody was sharing with me, or with a couple of us, I am not sure who, but here it is. Your mommy and your daddy may be Christian, but that doesn't automatically make you a Christian. Nobody is born a Christian. Let's settle that issue right now, eh?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Nobody is born a Christian, because everybody is born a sinner.
Amen.
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 Everybody is born a sinner. Whether your mommy and daddy are Christians or not, everybody is born a sinner. Nobody is born a Christian. Let's settle that issue right now. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So if mommy and daddy are Christians, then you will have to go to the same place where mommy and daddy went to become a Christian. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah. Just because you're born in a Christian family doesn't make you a Christian. You and me.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord? Does that settle the issue? Just because Pastor prayed for you, that doesn't make you a Christian.
Amen.
Just because God intervened in the course of your life, healed you of a great disease, amen, or saved you from an imminent accident where you could have died but you didn't, that doesn't make any one of us a Christian. Amen?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Yeah? Hallelujah. So while each of these things can be a part of the Christian experience, they are not what makes a Christian. Understand that? Hallelujah. I need to make that very clear. Eh? Praise the Lord. I think I used the example, you know, how many here you've been to a bread shop?
Bread shop.
When I bought bread from a bread shop. When you walk out, did you turn into a loaf of bread?
No.
No. Man, mommy and daddy may be doctors, but that doesn't automatically make you a doctor when you're born. You see how silly it is, eh? Many people claim to be Christians just because mommy and daddy are Christians. Amen?
Amen.
The same as somebody says, oh, my daddy is a doctor and my mommy is a doctor, I'm a doctor too.
Good.
Yeah, right. Tell that to somebody else. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Read the underlined one. 2, 3.
A Christian is a person who has, by faith, received and fully trusted in Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior.
I think this word here should be there. T-H-E-I-R. There. Okay, so a Christian is a person who has, by faith, remember we believe in the heart, received and fully trusted. Fully trusted. Amen?
Amen.
This is the reason when you got converted into Christianity, if you got idol worship items in your house, they need to be removed and renounced. Hear me now. Don't keep any of your idol worship items in your house. They need to be renounced and removed from your property. Because they are gateways for the demons to come and attack you, even though you're in the church.
Amen.
We dealt with that last year when we did the breaking of generational curse. Remember that?
Amen.
Yeah. Eh? Trusting in Jesus Christ as their only, only Savior. Because only Jesus Christ can only save. Nobody else.
Amen.
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 There's only one Savior. His name is?
Jesus.
Jesus. Got to settle this issue right here. These are absolutes. Eh? We cannot run away from it. These are absolutes. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Any questions so far?
Pastor.
Yeah.
Just one question.
Yep.
Most of the time, mostly Christians, or we have been moved away from Christ. We say we believe in Christ.
Huh?
We believe in Christ, but we are not acting as a believer.
Yeah.
We are not attending the church.
Yeah.
What we have to do, we not pray, we not worship.
Yeah.
There's one failure there.
Yeah.
And the second thing, he says, oh, I know everything about Christ.
Yeah.
Because I was going to the church.
Yeah.
I'm a Christian.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean you are going to church.
Yeah.
And you became a Christian now.
Yes. Very good question, eh?
Yeah.
Please understand this. Nobody knows everything about Christ.
No.
Nobody. Not even the pastors. Not even those people who got PhD from Bible college. Nobody knows everything about Christ. Amen?
Yeah.
Even the angels in heaven who are worshipping Parmeshwar 24/7, they don't know everything about Parmeshwar.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
But you know what the Bible says? They watch you and me and learn about Parmeshwar by watching the church.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. God does not reveal revelation knowledge to the angels. He revealed it to his church, to you and me. So they learn more and more of how Parmeshwar interacts with us. Even the angels who are in heaven, they don't even know everything. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And they've been doing it for millions and millions of years, and they still don't know everything. And we only been here 3 minutes, and we think we know everything. Yes. So nobody knows everything. Amen. This is the reason why you need to keep on coming to church. Keep on coming to Bible study. Keep on coming to prayer meeting. Hana, praise the Lord. Because nobody knows everything. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yeah. Good question. Does that answer your question a little bit? Yeah. Yeah. Praise the Lord. So, and this. Because most people say we are Christian, but we don't belong to a church. Eh? So, get this. It's like having, you know, how we have the fire, the wood. You take one piece of wood from this fire. Can this wood last long?
No.
No. After a while, this one will go dead. Eh?
Yeah.
Yeah? Now, it may not be as effective, this fire here, because one wood is missing. But they can still operate with us with this one. Eh?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. But you take this one, put it back here, lights up again. That's the way the church is. If you want to be on fire for God, stay in the church. We talked about the boat last week. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Maybe crowded, maybe uncomfortable sometimes because you have to be disciplined, corrected. Amen. But it's still better than outside the boat because the world is flooded with sin and people are drowning in sin and don't have any hope. You and I, we may be in the boat. It's a little bit crowded. But hey, it's better than swimming in sin. I hope you're a good swimmer if you want to walk out of the church. Amen? Because if you're not, man, it's going to take you away. Bang! The current, eh? The strong current of sin will just take you and you go further and further and further out. Amen? And sooner or later, we lose you, eh? Altogether. Other than that, Parmeshwar takes you early so that Satan doesn't get you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So many Christians die prematurely because they don't want to be a part of what Parmeshwar is building here on the earth. Be a part of the church. Don't run away from the church. Amen? This is your only hospital. This is your only boat for survival.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Don't jump the boat. Turn to somebody and say, stay in the boat.
Stay in the boat.
Amen. What's boat in Hindi?
Now.
Now. Stay in the now. Stay in the now. And stay in the now. Stay. Huh? Yeah. What am I going to do? Are they hold the oar and start rowing? row your boat. Row the boat. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. This thing gets easier when everybody's contributing. Don't be a takeaway Christian. Just come, eat what is prepared, go. Never contribute anything. Hallelujah. Ah. We call it takeaway Christians, eh? That's like going to one of these restaurants here. Go eat. Thank you very much. See you later. Are you got the bill here, pay? $50? Yeah. Amen. Kaku chiko na kanam butako. Amen. Don't love my time. My mask. Come and pray. Come and sing. Hallelujah. Come and sweep the church. Come and decorate the church. Praise the Lord. We need some window cleaners. You see the louvers in the church? Ah, it's got dust in it. Come and wipe the windows. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And the church say?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Read the last one, please. 2, 3, so.
So we will be
Here are a few examples. I better watch my grammar here. A Christian is a what?
Is
a new creation. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, what is he?
He is a new creation.
What happened to the old? And the new has come. Never been there before. Understand that. When you and I got born again, you are an entirely new species of being, never existed before.
Amen.
You're a brand new person.
Amen.
Amen? Brand new person. Fresh out from the box. 2 Corinthians 5:17, eh? Read the verse. This verse speaks 2, 3. Notice we become new by being in Christ or joined to Christ. Amen? Hallelujah. Can we join ourselves to Christ?
Come on.
Can we join ourselves to Christ? No. You cannot. That joining, hallelujah, that's like I can save myself. You cannot save yourself. Eh? Mm-hmm. The salvation process is the work of Parameshwar and only Parameshwar.
Mm-hmm.
Eh? Otherwise, you'll be claiming, hallelujah, oh, I did this and I was saved. No. So read that, the underlined part, 2, 3. And reversed, eh? Or dismantled, eh? Or taken apart. See, but nobody can undo salvation because none of us was involved in it. It was all the work of Parameshwar.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Come on. Stay with me. Don't lose me. Praise the Lord. Because it was all the work of Parameshwar. So in other words, no matter what you and I try to do, we cannot undo the work of salvation that's already been accomplished in us. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Eh? So a Christian is what?
Redeemed.
Redeemed means you've been purchased. You've been bought. Eh? You didn't pay the price. Somebody else paid the price. That's what redeemed is. Eh? I don't know what he said, but I just agree with it. Eh? I think it's something good. Praise the Lord. Something good, he said?
Yeah,
I just agree. Praise the Lord. Eh? So we didn't do any work on our part to earn our salvation. It is all the work of Parameshwar. Eh? He paid the price. He purchased us. Look at somebody and says, how much did you cost? Look at somebody say, I know, Omkari's over there. That's not the same idea. Eh? The people selling themselves, that's not the same idea. Because God alone, nobody else can pay the price. Eh? Nobody else can pay the price for your salvation and my salvation. Only Parameshwar can pay the price.
Amen. Amen.
Only Parameshwar can pay the price. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Can I ask the question then? Since you guys don't want to ask the question, I'm asking the question now. What is the price? What is the price? What is the price for your salvation and my salvation?
The blood of Jesus.
Huh? God sending his son, Jesus Christ. Eh? Hallelujah. To die on the cross. So that you and I could have eternal life. Salvation is free to you and me, but it costs Jesus Christ his life. Amen?
Amen?
It may be free, and it is free, but it costs Jesus his life. That's how much your salvation costs and my salvation. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Come on, give Jesus a clap offering tonight. Because if he didn't pay the price, then each one of us have to pay the price. Eh? There's only one problem. It won't satisfy the price of sin. Why? Because our blood is corrupted with sin itself. Corrupted blood cannot remove sin. Because it's already got sin in it. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That's like applying a medicine that's already got the virus that's attacking your body. It's useless. Amen.
Amen.
You need a medicine that will kill the virus, not help the virus. Amen?
Amen.
Ah. Praise the Lord. Any good doctor will tell you that, eh? Unless they get the certificate from the internet. Praise the Lord.
Ah.
Yeah. Because anybody can get anything from the internet these days. Praise the Lord. But if they went to proper medical school, they should know. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Read the explanation. For you know. 2, 3.
For you know that you are not creation of things such as you are about him, that you are redeemed from the end of the day of Christ, and that you are not from your father, but by the grace of God of Christ, a lamb without blemish or defect.
Well, without blemish or defect. Pure. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So each one of us, we weren't bought with paisa. There's not enough paisa in the whole world to pay for our salvation. There's not enough silver and gold in the whole world to pay for our salvation. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And look at this. Empty way of life handed down to to us from our forefathers. Do you see that? Yeah? That's talking about the generational curse. Amen? Generational curses. Amen. If you have some kind of, hallelujah, forefathers that have been involved in worshiping demons, in witchcraft, those things comes down to the next generations. Eh? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But with the precious blood of Jesus. That's the price for our salvation. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. The word redeem. 2, 3. Yeah? So there's a transaction that happens. There's a transaction for you shopkeepers and accountants and all that. So there's a transaction being made in the spirit when you got born again. When you and I got born again, there's a transaction that takes place in the spirit. Remember, before you and I were born again, were saved, which kingdom do we belong to?
Kingdom of darkness.
Kingdom of darkness. So when we got born again, there's a transaction that takes place. And now we've been escorted out of the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of
light.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So that's the reason why you can see that the things you used to love before are no longer, no longer desire for it or have an appetite for it. Amen. Come on, keep talking to me. Don't lose me. So read them out for a Christian. So you notice that. So for any Christian to lose their salvation, the process of redemption have to be revoked or undone. I don't think God is going to do that. He's not going to do that, eh? He's not trying to kick people out of heaven. He's trying to bring in as much as he can. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. And that should also be our attitude. Eh?
So
praise the Lord.
Amen.
Our attitude is, speak the truth to the people. Say, if you keep on going the way you're going, you're not going to last very long. Amen. Tell them the truth. But help them, hallelujah, to recognize that salvation is only through Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Any questions so far before we move forward? A Christian is
justified.
Now this is a legal terminology. We're entering into the legal realm now. Praise the Lord. So for all you lawyers in the congregation, you'll understand this. Read it for me. 2:3.
Therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God all our
sins. We've been justified through our Lord Jesus Christ. Carry on to justify.
To justify means to declare righteous all those who receive Jesus as their Lord and righteous.
Notice that. Okay? So let me ask the question. All the righteous people, can you please put your hand up? Hey, did you understand what you just read here? Read it again, read it again, to justify. 2:3. Now let me ask the question again. All the righteous people in the house, please, lift your hand up. Okay, all you people that didn't lift your hand up, you need to get saved after this meeting, okay? You just read it. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So, for a Christian, 2:3.
For a Christian, to salvation, God will get to all the rest of his world and I will care about what he has
declared. God will not do that. God will not undeclare. Amen. Hallelujah. God doesn't say one thing today, changes his mind tomorrow. Praise the Lord. The Bible says that he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. It's not changing. It's not changing. So righteous, yes, my brother. Yes.
Because it's really declared righteous by God.
Yes.
So who declared our righteousness?
God himself. God himself. This is the thing. When we got born again, when we got saved, when we received Jesus Christ into our hearts, to be our personal Savior and Lord, so what God did is that he made us to be in right relationship with him. Remember, before you got saved, you had no relationship with Parmeshwar. That line of communication, that line of relationship was broken because of sin. Amen? You were outside of the kingdom looking in, wanting to enjoy the benefits of the kingdom, but couldn't access it because of sin. Amen? And this is where we have to modify our evangelism efforts. Because most people who are in the kingdom of darkness, they want the benefits of being a Christian, but they don't want the Savior himself. Remember the package deal we were talking about? They only want the benefit, but they don't want to be a Christian. Because they don't realize that when you become a Christian, you enjoy all the benefits that is available through the package deal of salvation. Amen? Hallelujah. This is why salvation is very important. Praise the Lord. Amen. Because most people, they want healing, they don't want the healer. They want blessing, but they don't want the blesser. They want saving, but they don't want the savior. Amen. If you receive the savior, you receive a whole lot. A whole package. It comes with it. Don't just go for the benefit, eh? Because some people, they just want it easy all the time. Want it easy all the time. They don't want to work for it. They don't want to believe for it. They just want what somebody else has worked for. Amen? You look at somebody and say, I want his anointing. Man, did you know what took him to get to the level where he is? Eh? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen? The sacrifices he has to go through. The prayer he has to go through. Waking up early, staying up late. Hallelujah. Believing God. Crying. Hallelujah. And just seeking God. Amen. Hallelujah. While people go roam around, and they think they can just come to church and be anointed to sing in the choir. Gotta watch what you do now. The same anointing, hallelujah, that heals you can be the same anointing that kills you if you misuse it or abuse it. Anointing is like electricity. You connect and you cross the wire, it'll blow up in your face. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Maybe we'll have to teach that sometimes, eh? Ministry anointing. And how to look after it, protect it. Amen. Hallelujah. But you guys pray. Hallelujah. There's so much to learn. So much to learn. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So you understand now. Eh? Understand now. So God brings us to be in right alignment, right relationship with him through the new birth. Through the born again experience. Without the born again experience, you and I cannot have the right relationship with Parameshwar. It takes the new birth to do that.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So a Christian is what?
Promised
eternal life. How many of you going to heaven? All right. The people didn't put your hand up. We make sure tonight, eh? Hallelujah, come and receive the prayer. So you're going to heaven. It looks like some people are going to miss the boat if there's a flood tonight. Pastor? Ah. Praise the Lord. Let's read it. 2, 3.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whosoever believes in him.
So whoever believes, eh? Whoever believes, doesn't matter who you are, whether you're educated or not, whether you only go to class 6 or whether you go USP. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Whether you come from a high caste or a low caste, whether you come from a chiefly clan or a common clan. Hallelujah. Whether you're working or not working, doesn't matter whoever you are. Hallelujah. Whatever you are or whatever you may be experiencing, you can be saved. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Believe in the heart and confess with the
mouth.
Amen. I'm glad that you got it right. Praise the Lord. Eternal life. 2, 3.
Eternal life is the promise of eternity forever in heaven and for all those
who believe and you will have eternal
life.
For a Christian. 2, 3.
For a Christian,
hallelujah. Is God a promise breaker?
No.
No. Hallelujah. I think he said it in Psalms 89 verse 34. My covenant I will not break nor alter, a word that has gone out of my mouth. Psalms 89 verse 34. Somewhere around there. Check it out. Just to see whether the pastor is saying the right thing or not. I know, Auntie Oli will do that for me. Praise the Lord. Eh? My covenant I will not break, nor alter the word that has gone out of my mouth or lips. Amen. Any questions so far? About salvation? About your hallelujah? If you're not sure, let me ask a question before we go. If you were to die tonight, God forbid it, but I'm just saying, hypothetically, if you go to sleep tonight and that's it, kalas, marge, eh? Kalas, finish. You don't greet tomorrow morning. Where would you be? Would you be in heaven with Parameshwar? Or would you go down there with Satan, devil, demons? How many are going to heaven? Put your hands up. How many are you going to hell? Put your hands up. How many are you not sure? Put your hands up. You're not just not sure. Oh, I don't know, Pastor. I don't know. I don't know. Put your hand up. You're not sure. Anybody not sure tonight? Okay. Everybody sure? That's good. A Christian is guaranteed glorification. Glorification is just a fancy word for you be taken up. Praise the Lord. So when Jesus comes with all his angels and they sound the trumpet. Well, the trumpet doesn't sound like that, but anyway, you know. Hallelujah. You all go up in the rapture. Praise the Lord. Okay, read it for me. 2, 3. He also called
those he called, he also justified. Those he justified, he also glorified. As we learn in Romans 5:1, justification is declared at the moment of faith. According to Romans 8:13, glorification is guaranteed for all those whom God justifies.
Okay. So justification, hallelujah, happens at the moment you got saved. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Happens at the moment you got saved. So the day you got saved, I hope you keep a record of your spiritual birth date. Eh? Praise the Lord. So the moment you got saved, that's the moment you are justified. That's the moment you be made with right relationship with Parameshwar. Praise the Lord. Glorification will happen later on. Eh? Praise the Lord. So read glorification 2:3.
Glorification refers to a Christian receiving a perfect resurrection body in heaven.
Okay. The good thing about this new body, this resurrection body, we don't have to put paint on it, eh? To look nice. You will look nice. You don't have to put lipstick, makeup, mascara, eyelashes, nothing. Yeah? Because how are you going to improve it? Yeah. You know, I know the girls spend plenty money in makeup, eh? And today too, the boys too spend plenty money in makeup. And all the girls say?
Amen!
All the boys, I hope you're listening. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. So there won't be any makeup shop in heaven. Get delivered from makeup. No makeup shop. You're not going to update or modify. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You're not going to have, you know, implants or anything like that to modify. I don't look nice. Oh, I don't look nice. Right? Let me go surgery. Eh? Have implants. No, nothing. You will be perfect. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
If a Christian, 2:3.
If a Christian gets a salvation, Romans 8:13.
Amen. Hallelujah. So our glorification is guaranteed. Praise the Lord. At the moment we receive Jesus Christ as our personal Savior and Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Eh? Hallelujah. Myself, I just want to know, hallelujah, is there going to be any good movie on the flight up? Amen?
Amen.
Yeah. Just want to watch a good movie as we're going up. I don't know, maybe Vera will say, what's, you know, are we having any lunch or anything while we're going flying up with, you know, ask the angel, did you cook something on the flight? Hallelujah. You got any microwave in this flight? Just heat something for me. Praise the Lord. Cup of coffee would be nice or something like that. Huh? No more cooking, eh? No more cooking. Because we'll be eating angel food, eh? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And all the ladies say, no more cooking. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Ah, eh? Ah, no more pala, no more, eh? Ah, no more curry chicken, nothing. We don't have to worry about that because the angels are going to be doing all the work. Praise the Lord. Can you imagine the food in heaven? Who's looking forward to heaven now? Yeah, before we go there, please, there's work to be done here at Christ Worship Center. Hana, plenty work, plenty. Barka, barka work. Many more illustrations. 2, 3.
Many more illustrations of our close and salvation can be shared here. In order to meet you, may it become completely clear in the description of our salvation. Most, if not all, of what brothers and sisters have for us in the
Christ, Jesus
Christ, is the same thing that we need to
believe in the
salvation.
Okay. Ah, praise the Lord. Eh? Did you understand all that? So salvation cannot be reversed. 2, 3. Okay, a Christian, go on.
A Christian cannot be unduly created. Redemption cannot be undone. Eternal life cannot be lost and still be considered eternal. If a Christian can lose salvation, God would therefore have on his own being and then his mind two things that the scripture tells us God never does.
Praise the Lord. God never changes his mind. Hallelujah. His word is forever established in heaven, the Bible says. Amen. His word is forever established in heaven. Heaven and earth will pass away, but his word will not pass away. Hallelujah. He's the same yesterday, today, and
forever.
If he's the same yesterday, today, and forever, so is his word. Amen? If God remains the same, so is his word. Because God and his word go together. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
In the beginning was the word. And the word was with
God.
And the word was
God.
Praise the Lord. The most frequent objections to the belief that a Christian cannot lose salvation are: number one, read it.
What does those who are Christians have got to believe in and immoral lifestyle?
And number two,
what about those who are Christians but they have been in a faith and in a Christ?
The problem? Okay, so the problem is who are Christians. Now the Bible declares, 2, 3.
The Bible declares that all Christians do not know what we are in the world.
Eh? 1 John 3:6, and the Bible declares?
The Bible declares that anyone who lacks the faith is faith in the
They never truly was a Christian. Notice, a true Christian is not looking for ways to sin. Yeah? A true Christian is not looking for ways how they can sin without being recognized or punished by Parameshwar. That's not the attitude of a true Christian. Therefore, 2, 3.
Therefore, my
God, is valid. Christians
do not believe in moral lifestyle, nor do they reject a faith and deny Christ. Such actions are proof that they will never be able.
Eh? So, this is why I said it. That's why we were dealing with believe in the heart and confess with the mouth. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Because you can just not repeat the prayer without any faith applied to it.
Amen.
You cannot repeat the prayer without any faith applied to it. Faith must be applied to the prayer. Amen. If you just pray the prayer just by mouth only, then obviously you're not saved, eh? Even though you're saying the salvation prayer. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
This is what we have to make sure. Say the salvation prayer with faith applied to it. Amen.
Amen.
And know a Christian cannot what? Understand that. No, a Christian cannot lose their salvation. Amen?
Amen.
You cannot lose your salvation, eh? If you're a genuine, true believer in Christ. Let's finish it off. Nothing can separate. 2, 3.
Nothing can separate a Christian from God's love. Nothing can remove a Christian from God's hand.
God is
so willing and able to guarantee.
Presence without fault and with great joy to the only God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, power, and authority through Jesus Christ, our Lord, before all ages, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So notice that God keeps us. God protects us. Hallelujah. Eh? Once we are saved. And also, can I say this? God also has been protecting us. Excuse me. Before you got saved, think about the times you could have died when you didn't know Christ. But He saved you and me all the time until the day we got born again. Can you remember that? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Just give permission, a clap offering tonight. Amen. So we have all the scriptures here. John 10, 28 and 29. I give them eternal life and they will never perish. No one will snatch them away from me. For my Father has given them to me. And He is more powerful than anyone else. So no one can take them from
me.
Not even Satan. Not even Satan. Satan cannot snatch your life away from Parmeshwar once you got saved. Amen.
Amen.
This is the reason why we emphasize that when you pray for your unsaved loved ones, pray that Parmeshwar will cover them and protect them with His blood. So that they don't die before they get saved. Understand that? Who has started praying for their unsaved loved ones? Since we start touching this, who has started praying for their unsaved loved ones? You better get started. Don't delay. Don't put it off. Don't postpone it. Yeah? Start praying for your unsaved loved ones. Praise the Lord. Especially after going through this study. Don't hold back. Believe for the whole family to come in. Yeah? On your father's side and on your mother's side. Everyone. Believe for everyone to come in. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I think in the Faith Clinic group page, there was a salvation prayer posted up this afternoon. I put it up. Is it this afternoon or early last night? I'm not sure, but it's there. You can go and check it out. Jude 24 and 25. Can you read it? 2, 3.
Now. And to present your
followers
before the presence of
the Lord,
Jesus, to God our
Savior, who alone is wise, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. Last scripture, 2, 3.
And now, O Lord, we will
keep you from stumbling. Who will bring you into His glorious presence, innocent of sin and with great joy. All glory to Him, who alone is God our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Yes, glory, majesty, power, and authority belong to Him in the beginning, now, and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's all stand up, please. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Just say a word of thank you. to Parmeshwar. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What we've learned tonight. Hallelujah. Just say thank you. Hallelujah. Wonderful Jesus. Wonderful Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We praise you. We praise you. We praise you. We thank you. Yes, Lord.
I thank you.
You're the awesome God. Hallelujah. You're the great God. You're the majestic God. There's no other God like you, God. Hallelujah. You're the Alpha and the Omega. The beginning and the end. The first and the last. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. From eternity to eternity, you are God. Thank you, Jesus.
So we can
hallelujah. Your wonderful Jesus. Wonderful Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Once more.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Pastor Tish,
hallelujah.
Can you say a word of prayer for us to end this
hallelujah.
Meeting, please?
Thank you, Lord. Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh,
Rabashikala.
Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes,
hallelujah.
God.
Hallelujah. Lord Jesus, I thank you for your wonderful sure. time and opportunity that you have given to us.
Yes, Lord.
I thank you for the wonderful teacher that was in the midst of us. He was counseling and leading us and delivering the word that touched our mind and hearts, Lord Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that the Spirit of God that was in the midst of us, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Lord Jesus, I thank for each and everyone that has been given the opportunity, that opportunity has been given from you, Lord Jesus.
Yes,
that those who are here, Lord, Lord, help them, guide them, Lord, so they can grow and use for your kingdom, Lord. And they Jesus. Also can go and spread your word as you want us
Jesus.
To deliver your word, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
I know, Lord Jesus, it's time for you for to come, Lord Jesus. I know it's a time for us to be prepared. When you're going to come and take us over there, where you
yes,
need
Lord.
Us.
Yes, Lord.
Lord Jesus, I thank you. Whatever we have learned, it still remains in us, Lord. Give us the wisdom, Lord. I pray for our wisdom, Lord, as we lose, Lord. Help us, Lord. Touch our minds, Lord. Touch each and everyone's mind, Lord. So it can be kept as an entry box, Lord Jesus. I thank you, Lord Jesus, for this time. To accept this, my prayer, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen. 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 Amen.